I would like to welcome you to come and visit the country of Spain for the next few minutes to the city of Almería, where we have worked for over 35 years. Well, all the way from its beautiful sunsets off the Mediterranean Sea to the Alhambra in the city of Granada. We started in the city of Almería, a city that's now over 200,000 people, because we wanted to tell them about Jesus.
We started our ministry with me teaching Bible stories in our home to the children in the neighborhood. Dave made contact with the young people by playing basketball in the streets with them.
Eventually, we would move out of our home where we were having our church services. But with God's blessing, after some time, we outgrew that building and had to purchase another building. But with purchasing a new building comes challenges. We always thank God for the offerings and the gifts that were given to help us do the remodeling that would take over a year before we could have our inauguration service.
And who showed the moon?
So many pictures, so many faces, so many stories, and not enough time to tell them all. But for a moment, let us look at just a couple of them. Roberto the lawyer, who was an atheist, now a believer, after a long 3 years of listening, came to claim Christ as his Savior, and now a regular preacher of the gospel at the church. Tomas, an older man, came to us with his wife Pepa because of the food bank. He is responsible for many people that are coming to our church now.
Ava and her children were looking for answers when they came to our church. After a few months, they came to know the Lord as Savior. Thank you to all who prayed with us for husband and father Richard, who after 2 years made his decision for Christ and now is a faithful member. One of Dave's favorite ministries was when we gave cooking classes at our church. Our ladies shared their favorite recipes, and we had a time of devotions for them to invite their friends to hear the gospel.
A mission conference is the most important part of the year when people are encouraged to stretch their faith and give to the cause of worldwide missions. Every year our mission giving increases, allowing us to take on more missionaries, Tommy Tucker in Thailand, an orphanage in India, the camp, and other missionaries that are in Spain.
Our music ministry has grown throughout the years as the Lord continues to bless us with talented people, both young and old. The young people stay quite active. They have 6 different youth conferences, including our own. They'll travel up to 7 hours just to be with other Christian young people. Almost all of the young people and many of the adults help with the Vacation Bible School. The last day, we have a carnival with games, food, and prizes. with a special prize for the child who brings the most visitors, and we always have several parents visiting. This is the day when I teach and focus on the plan of salvation in my story with an invitation to accept the Lord as Savior. Working with the food bank has helped our church grow. Most Wednesdays, the church gives away fruits and vegetables after service. Those who came on Wednesday for food are now attending on Sundays also, and we've had the privilege to lead some of them to the Lord. Tomas has now taken over that ministry with his wife Josefa and me helping. Many who were once unreachable now find joy in hearing God's word. Camp is an important part of our summers. We work at Camp Monte Calvario, started by Levon Waters. I help with the cooking and crafts, and it's a joy when I can talk with a child about salvation. There are four camps a year covering all ages. Dave helps with barbecuing, maintenance, sports, and most of all, it's his privilege when he's asked to preach. All of the workers are volunteers and pay to go. This keeps the cost down, making it more affordable. When necessary, we'll pay for a camper to go.
Baseball has become an important part of the church ministry. It has only one purpose, and that is to reach out to young people. Many people that attend our church now are a result of this ministry. About half of the youth who attend church through playing baseball have come to know Christ as their Savior. A league that was formed by me with help from City Hall giving me a piece of property to use as a baseball field gave me the opportunity to witness to them about God's loving grace. Our yearly baseball banquet, a Mexican dinner with door prizes, gives me this opportunity not only to witness to the ball players, but they also are encouraged to invite family and friends to the dinner, expanding our outreach ministry. Going into the high schools to teach baseball opens the door to new contact and also opened the door for me to get into the Catholic religion class to be able to witness to hundreds of kids who would have never heard how to be saved. I was the very first person ever in Spain, non-Catholic, to get into the religion class to give testimony about God's saving grace. A great blessing to us was when we started our third work down the road in Roquetas del Mar, about 30 minutes from our Spanish work. But it was a work that was in English with the Africans. They were there with their families, praising God, and now we've been able to merge them with our Spanish work, and that has really been a blessing to both churches. This is Pastor Antonio Liscano. After the church had prayed for many years, waiting upon God's blessing, Antonio came to us. He had all the things in his personal life that the church would require of him to be the new pastor. He's a humble man, servant attitude, and he knows how to sacrifice for the good of the people. It was a tremendous Saturday when the pastors came from all over the country of Spain to question him on his doctrinal beliefs. They gave the recommendation to the church to accept him. The following Sunday, the people would vote. Then the men of the church would come, fulfilling what is in the book of Acts, and lay their hands upon him, giving their blessings. We give God all the honor and glory and worship for bringing this man to take this work and to guide and direct them spiritually for God's glory.